Is your Google ad eligible but still you are not able to see any impressions or views? In that case, this video can certainly help you. There are four most important things that you need to consider so that your ads are getting the impressions and views as well. So I'm going to help you with step by step instructions so that your ad starts running. So let's get started. So I'm right now in my Google Ads account. You could see that, okay, there are many ads that are running, but this one, it is not running, right? So it says eligible and there are no impression nor views on this. So what exactly could be the reason? Let me show you with respect to this particular ad, and later I'm also going to tell you the best practices so that your ad is always going to run. Now the first thing, the first most important thing could be like the daily budget, whatever we have set, or the total campaign budget, whatever we have set, it might be less. That could be one reason. So in this case, I have set it as 100 rupees per day. So let me just increase it to maybe say around 300 rupees per day. Okay. So that's something that I'm doing. Now this is the daily budget, what I have updated. Correct. Now the other thing could be the cost per view, what we have set, right? So if your cost per view is very less, okay, and if competitors are bidding for a higher price, in that case also you may not see any impressions. So what you need to do for that is increase your cost per view. Maybe say, for example, from 0.10, I'm going to increase to 0.20. Even after a couple of days, if you see that, okay, it is still not getting any impressions, then you can certainly increase to 0.3. So cost per view depends upon the topic, it depends upon the kind of content we are creating. So it might certainly increase or decrease as well. Now, once your campaign starts running, based on that, you'll be able to identify what should be the best cost per view that you can set as well. Correct. Now, these are two most important things. Now, after that, there could be something that where your target audience may be really narrow as well. Okay. So let me tell you how exactly to identify that. So I'm right now in the same campaign. Now let me just go to demographics. Okay. So maybe you might have selected a particular set of age. Maybe say, for example, you have set maybe around just 25 to 34. And next could be placements. Now this is one of the most important thing. If you have selected placements, and again, if that is leading to a narrow target audience, even in that case, your ad may not be shown, right? So if I just click on my placements, now this, for this particular ad, whatever I have set up and which is not running, the reason could be I have set the placements against these channels. Okay, I have set against these YouTube channels. Now that means maybe it is not able to find more audience for this, because of which this ad may not be running, right? So we have to increase the target audience for this. And in some cases, if you see that, okay, you have set locations, and if you have a very narrow location, then you might have to expand your location. Now say, for example, in this case, I have given India, so that is good. Now if you're given any particular place or something or a location, if that is too narrow, even in that case, you may not be able to get the impressions, correct? Now these are the basic things that you need to consider. Now let me just go to this particular ad. So now the major reason why this ad may not be running is because I have used a brand name. So using a brand name, it really limits Google or YouTube to show ads to a larger audience. So in this case, I will remove the YouTube trademark. Okay, I'm just going to click on save ad. So when I say about trademark, it would be YouTube, it could be Facebook, it could be AdSense. So now I have done that. Let me just go to quickly to all campaigns. Again, you can see one of this ad, which is eligible, but it says all ads limited by policy. Correct. Now if I just see here, it says trademarks in ads text. Correct. That's what it is saying. Now let me show you. If you see something like this, see, sometime it may be showing like this and sometime it may not be showing, but still there might be a restriction on the limitation of your ad being running. Okay. Now if you go to this ad, particular ad, now you can see here how many channels can be created in one Gmail account. Now again, this is a trademark, right? Now to avoid this restriction, so I've seen like some people who run the ads, they might also misspell the words. Say, for example, instead of saying as Gmail, they may say as G-M-A-A-I-L, Gmail, okay? Now AdSense, they might say AdSense, right? So something like that, where it does not exactly say the brand name here, but still your ad can get approved as well. Now, just say, for example, save ad. What I'm showing right now is the best practices which you can follow so that once your ad is eligible, it immediately starts running and you start seeing the impressions as well. Okay. So setting the budget and date. So I'm going to select as a daily and I'm going to set the budget as 300. See, initially you can set a slightly higher budget. And once your ad starts running and it starts getting impression, now if you want to reduce the daily budget, you can reduce it. So in many cases, I might set a higher budget in the beginning and slowly I would set a lower budget as well. Correct? Now that's something that you can do. Location, you can select all countries or India or select multiple countries as well. So make sure it is actually broad. Language, I have selected as Hindi and English. So that is fine. Now here is one most important thing. Inventory type. If your ad is not running, okay, it might be because we would have selected standard inventory or something. Now, if you select expanded inventory, that means it is going to have still more larger reach. Okay, so it's best that you can select this. Demographics again here. So make sure you have a good number of age criteria that you have selected. So make sure you have a good number of audience which can be targeted. So placement, where exactly your ad should be shown, that is something that you can select here. If you are not too specific, then you can just leave it like that so that it has more audience. Now, maximum CPV bid, that is what is the maximum that you are willing to pay per view. So one thing that I would say is to start with, set a higher CPV, maybe say for example 0.2 or 0.3, okay. So that would help you to start the ads running. Okay. Now after that, once you start seeing the actual cost per view, then you can reduce it as well. Okay. By doing this, you can certainly get your ad running once it is eligible. Now I'm going to show you how exactly you can see whether you can reduce the CPV once your ad start running. This video cost per view is 0.32. This is 0.24. This is 0.23, 0.17. Okay. So I have set the cost per view as 0.30. So I can just make this, I can edit this and set as 0.17. That means going forward, whatever view I'm going to get, this is the price I'm willing to pay. Correct? These steps, whatever I shared right now, should help your ad running and seeing the impressions and views. If it is not helping, then the next thing that you can do is create a new campaign by following all the things that I have mentioned as best practices. So that should help your ad seeing the impressions and views as well. And if you still need support, then the best thing to do is contact the support team, right? So how to contact Google support team? Just click on the help symbol that you see in the AdSense account. Click on contact us. Once you do that, select the issue. Say for example, ad enabled but not running. Click on next. Say for example, ads are not running. Select the ads account. Next step. Okay. Click on next step. So you have both chat and email option. So please do note that, okay, chat is available only for a particular time. So you can just click on that symbol below and it says Monday from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Correct. So if I click here, Saturday and Sunday, they don't support. Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. So you have to contact only during this time, during Indian time. Okay. So in that case, you can certainly get the chat support. If not, you can send an email. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions related to Google Ads, just comment below. I'll be more than happy to answer. And just click on the info card at the top and you'll be able to find other related videos which are related to Google Ads. Certainly it can help you as well. So thanks for watching. Please do like, subscribe and hit that bell notification and select all notifications so that you don't miss any videos from this channel. See you in the next video.